everyone. My name is Vicky, and I'm from Santa Ursula BSD Junior High School. Now, first of all, I would like to thank God for bringing all of us here today, and also for the chance to participate in this competition. I hope that after listening to my speech, all of you will be inspired to make changes for the good of our future. So, enough about that. Without further ado, let's get started. I'm sure everyone here knows that education has an incredibly important role throughout our life. It's basically the playmaker of our life. It plays a great role in shaping our future and professional career. It also helps us to develop personality and earn recognition and respect in today's society. Education will be very beneficial for us in the future, and it is an essential part of the human life. However, not everyone can receive education comfortably. Take children in disadvantaged areas, for example. It has been shown that students from low-income households tend to end up earning less in the future, have little to no access to healthcare, suffer from obesity, and at a greater risk of homicide and violent assault. We have every reason to possibly need to look closely at the educational difficulties that poverty creates and take active steps to overcome this challenge. Yet, we haven't seen any significant change in the country regarding this matter. There is still a staggering difference between the rich and the poor regarding education. People still outright downplay the influence poverty has on it. They often point to a few specific schools that have beaten the odds. But we cannot assume that if some schools have succeeded, others will follow in its footsteps. Ignoring the ill effects of poverty on student learning, unfortunately, comes at a great cost. As we are now seeing all around the country, requiring all schools to meet the same standards for all of their students, regardless of family backgrounds, will inevitably lead to shortfalls and undesirable outcomes. In order to become a prosperous country, we must first fix this growing problem. Here are a number of educational challenges worsened by poverty and some effective ways to address them. First, disadvantaged children often suffer from poor health and nutrition, which can be corrected by high-quality early childhood and preschool programs. School-based clinics, nurses, and mental health counselors can also help older students. Second of all, early exposure to rich language boosts cognitive development. So we need to help poor parents and other caregivers read to their children, and also engage them in conversations. Lastly, poor parents cannot give children the enrichment experiences that privileged families routinely provide. Extracurricular activities matter most for the poor. However, we also mustn't let schools off the hook. Schools must provide the most effective teachers possible and offer additional supportive services. Because, in order to be successful, education in impoverished areas must deliver to disadvantaged students the supports and experiences that middle-class students usually get at home. The bottom line is, for the sake of our future, we cannot continue to ignore the challenges of educating unprivileged children. Education shouldn't be a luxury only for the rich. Everyone should have the same chance at it, for it is one of the most basic human rights. Remember, Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world." That's all for me today. I'm sorry if there are any mistakes, and thank you very much for your attention.